Russia calls for dialogue between Afghanistan, Tajikistan. Russia's foreign ministry has urged the Islamic Emirate and Tajikistan to resolve tensions via dialogue and restrain from physical actions. The spokesperson of Russia's foreign ministry, Alexei Zaitsev, said reports indicate that both sides have stationed forces on their borders. "We observe with concern the growing tensions in Tajik-Afghan relations amid mutually strong statements by the leadership of the two countries," Zaitsev said. Tajikistan President Emomali Rahmon has repeatedly called for the formation of an inclusive government in Afghanistan. The Deputy Prime Minister of the Islamic Emirate, Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar, in reaction to Rahmon's comments, said such remarks are interfering in Afghanistan's internal affairs. Following the remarks, Zabihullah Mujahid, Deputy Minister for the Ministry of Information and Culture, tweeted on September 25 that dozens of special forces had been sent to Takhar, a province bordering Tajikistan. Local officials in Badakhshan province have also said that around 1,200 special forces are on alert in areas bordering Tajikistan. Tajikistan's staged a military parade near its border with Afghanistan. "We hope that our relations with these countries do not escalate to the extent that we have a physical confrontation," said Saeed Kosti, spokesman for the Ministry of Interior. The Islamic Emirate, however, rejected reports that it had sent special troops to the border areas with Tajikistan. Meanwhile, Mohammad Niam Wardak, the spokesman for the Islamic Emirate political office in Doha, said they will not allow any country to interfere in Afghanistan affairs. "The Islamic Emirate policy from the beginning has been to neither interfere in any country's internal affairs nor allow any country to interfere in Afghanistan's internal affairs. Because it is better that any country resolves its own internal problems," he said. "If such problems are created for Afghanistan, they will make the people of Afghanistan suffer. In the current situation, we need to have good political and trade relations with Central Asia," said Aziz Marej, a political analyst.